Mr. Durakovic, you're here at the conference on Srebrenica 20 years after. You yourself are a survivor of Srebrenica and Jepa. Do you feel that your presence here in The Hague is representing the interests of those who were victims of the massacre, the genocide 20 years ago?
I think many people represent the interest of those who were massacred in Srebrenica. All survivors have a story to tell. For me, this was more important. It was not about representation. It was more about fact-finding. Finally, after 20 years, after Srebrenica, we are sitting in a room where a majority of the people had something to do with Srebrenica, either impacted in a positive or otherwise negative way. So Srebrenica genocide took place. To me, it was also very important to see this as some sort of truth commission. 20 years later, most of these individuals who are sitting around the table are retired or at the end of their career. And this is not the court in which everyone should be judged or punished for things they have done or failed to do. But I thought it would be to the victims of Srebrenica genocide, who are mostly civilian, we need at least to be human enough to say, we're human, we made a mistake, and I'm really sorry. I have to say that I'm disappointed. The conference is still not over. I hope there is plenty of time for the key decision makers and participants to actually step forward and to say this. And I think to me, as a survivor, this would be very important, as well as all the other survivors of Srebrenica genocide.
The conference also focuses on the period between the establishment of the safe area in 1993 and the fall of the enclave on July 11, 1995. How important do you think that this conference is focusing on that particular period?
Well, the conference could have focused on the beginning of the Balkans wars. You know, everything that happened in Srebrenica is escalation of ethnic cleansing and genocide in making, which was happening throughout this particular region. Let's not forget about the geostrategic, the goals of the regime of Slobodan Milosevic, and that is creation of Greater Serbia. Srebrenica and later on Kosovo was the last stage in this particular goal, where Slobodan Milosevic and those who followed his politics were trying to achieve.
What is it that you think the people of Bosnia, whether Bosniaks, Croats or Serbs, can take from this conference?
Well, as I said, I think it's important for all of us to reflect on what happened and to dig deep inside of us and to see what went wrong. And I think this conference is more important to some extent to the participants of the conference, as well as the victims of Srebrenica genocide. But I think this conference should also contribute, clear any misunderstandings, if there are some, who did what and at what time and why not. So people can move on. We can move on with our lives. We can try to never forget, but at least try to move on and work towards a better future for the sake of everyone, so for the sake of the children who are now being born in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Mr. Durakovic, thank you very much.
Thank you.